Good morning children, welcome to grade 4 mathematics online class. So children, we are dealing with the unit 5, that is factors and multiples, isn't it ma? So in the previous class we have discussed about some filling the blanks based on this lesson. Have you learned that? Yes, I hope you learned everything, okay ma? Just we can recall the things what we learned in the previous class, okay? So what is a factor? Yes, a factor of a number divides the number completely without remainder, isn't it? A factor of a number divides the number completely without remainder. And we know that every number has the factors 1 and itself, isn't it? So 1 is the smallest factor and also the number itself is the greatest factor of that given number, isn't it? So today we are going to see how to find out the factor of the given number using division. So in the previous class we have discussed about how to find the factors of the given numbers using multiplication number. No, today we are going to see about how to find out the factors using division method. Okay, so let's start today's class. So children, Roman number 3, find the factors of the following numbers using division. Find the factors of the following numbers using division. So we know that factor of a number divides the number completely without remainder. No, so here we are going to divide the numbers and we are going to find out the factors. Okay, ma. So first question, we are going to do the factors of 56. Okay, we want the factors of 56. So first we can write solution and we can divide the 56 by 1. So 56 is the dividend, that's a given number, and we have to start to divide the number by 1. Okay, divisor is 1. We have to start the divisor from 1. Okay, so here, look at here ma, so in the 5, how many 1s are there? Yes, 5, 1 is 5, isn't it? So 5 into 1 is 5. Next, we can subtract the 5 and 5, so 5 minus 5 is 0. Next, we can bring down the 6, okay, next, 1's place value. Now, we have 6, so in the 6, how many 1s are there? Yes, 6, 1s are 6, no, so we can write 6 in the quotient and we can write 6 here. 6 minus 6 is 0. So we got the 0 as the balance, isn't it ma? So we got the remainder as 0. So 1 and 56 are the factors of 56. We know that all the numbers, that is every number, have the factors as 1 and itself. So here 1 and 56, okay, the number itself, we got the factors. Okay, next we can divide the 56 by, next value is 2 and after 1 is 2. So we can divide the 56 by 2. So in first we can take the tens place value, that means 5. Okay, so in the 5, how many 2s are there ma? In 5, how many 2s are there? Yes sir, 2 2s are 4, no, so we can write 2 in the quotient and we can write 2 2s are 4, no, 2 2s are 4. So next we can subtract 5 minus 4, so 5 minus 4 is 1, isn't it? 5 minus 4 is 1. Next we can bring down the ones place value, that means 6 we can bring it. So 1 and 6, it will make it as 16. Okay, now we have 16. So in the 16, how many 2s are there? How many 2s are inside the 16 ma? Yes, 8 2s are 16. No. So 8 into 2. 8 into 2 is 16. Next, 16 minus 16 is 0. Okay. So when you divide the 56 by 2, we get the remainder 0. So we can say 28. Okay. 2 and 28 are the factors of 56. Okay. Next, we can divide this 56 by 3. Okay, listen, if you are going to divide by 3, means here we have 1, 3 is 3, isn't it? Next, you will get 2 remainder. So 2 and 6 is 6, 26. So in 26, how many 3s are there, ma? Yes, we have 8 3s are 24 and you will get 2 as a remainder. So we can't able to take it, the 3 as a factor of 56, isn't it? So we can divide by 4. So we can check it. By 4 means, yes, 1 4 is 4, isn't it? So in the 10th place we have 5. So 1 4 is 4. Next we can subtract the 5 minus 4. So 5 minus 4 is 1, isn't it? So we will get remainder as 1. Next we can bring the 1's place down, that is 16. So in 16, how many 4's are there? Yes, 4 4's are 16. 4 4's are 16. So 16 minus 16 is what, ma? 16 minus 16 is 0. So here we got the remainder 0. So we can say 4 and 14. Okay, 4 and 14 are the factors of 56. Okay, 4 and 14 are the factors of 56. So next we can check it for the 5. Okay,
So in the 5 table, 5 multiplication table, is we will get 56 as the answer. No, no, we know that 5 and 0 only will get in this ones place. No, so we can't able to divide the 56 by 5. Next we can check it for 6 table. So in 6 table also we will get 9, 6 are 54, isn't it? So if you subtract means we will get 2 as the remainder. So it's not possible to divide. Next we can check it for 7. Yes, so we will get 8, 7 are 56, isn't it, ma? So we can divide the 56 by 7. So we can write 8 here, 8, 7 are 56. So 56 minus 56 is 0. Okay, 56 minus 56 is 0. Next 8 table, 8 table same numbers only get. So if you divide by 8 means you will get as a quotient as 7. So no need to write again. So same factors only. 7 and 8 will be the factors of 56. Then check it for 9. 9 we won't get, isn't it, ma? Won't get. So 10 table also we won't get. So these are the factors, okay. When you dividing by 1, 2, 4 and 7, you will get the remainder as 0, okay. If you divide 56 by 1, 2, 4 and 7 as a divisor, you will get the remainder as 0. So from here, we can write, thus, so we can write the divisors first, okay. Divisor is 1, comma, the next divisor is 2, comma, then next divisor is 4, comma, next divisor is 7. Next, we can write the quotients from here, okay, from the right side to left we can write. So what's the quotient first one? Yes, 8, comma, the next quotient is 14, comma, next quotient is 28, and at the last we have 56 as quotient. So we can write 56, okay. So thus we can write the divisors, that means 1, comma, 2, comma, next divisor 4, comma, 7, comma, next we can write the quotient from the right side to left side, that means 8, 14, 28 and 56 are the factors of what, which number? 56, okay. So we can write the answers thus: 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, 14, 28 and 56 are the factors of 56. Have you understood this? So when you are dividing the numbers, you will get the remainder 0, okay. When you, if you want to find out the factors of a given number, means we have to divide it from the 1, okay. From, we have to start from 1, because all the numbers has the factors as 1 and itself, no. So we have to start from 1. Next we have to check it and do it, okay, ma. If you get 0 only, that numbers we can take it as the factors of the given number. Otherwise we can't able to take the numbers as the factors of the given number. Next we can do the next problem. So next question we have 75, okay. We have to find out the factors of 75 by using the division method, okay. So we can start to divide the 75 by 1 first, okay. We can take the divisor as 1 first. So in the 7, how many 1s are there, my 7 1s are 7. So 7 into 7, 1 is 7. So next we can subtract, 7 minus 7 is 0. Next we have to bring down the 1's place value, that means 5 have to bring. So in the 5, how many 1's are there? Yes, 5, 1 is 5. So 5 into 1 is 5. The next we have to subtract, 5 minus 5 is 0. So we got the remainder 0. So we can say the 1 and the number itself, that means 1 and 75 are the factors of 75. Next we can check it for 2. Take it 75 as the dividend and 2. Is it possible to divide by 2, ma? No, because in the 1's place, in the number, it is ending with the 5, no, it's not an even number, it's an odd number, no. So we, if you have the even number in the 1's place only, we can divide it by 2. So next we can check it for 3, okay, 3 table, okay, ma. So if you taking 3 means here, how many 3's are in the 7? Yes, 2 3's are 6, isn't it? 2 3's are 6 we will get. 2 into 3 is 6, isn't it? So we can subtract the 7 minus 6. 7 minus 6 is 1. Next we have to bring the next value down, that is 5. Okay. Then this, ma? So first we are divided by 1. Next we have divided by 3. So if we are dividing by 3 means first we have to take it the 10th place first. So in the 10th place we have 7. So how many 3's are in the 7 minus 2 3's are 6. 2 3's are 6. So 7 minus 6 is 1. 7 minus 6 is 1. Next we have to bring down the 1's place value. That means 5 we have to bring. So if you bring the 5 down means we will get 1 and 15. Sorry, 1 and 5 is 15. Okay, 1 and 5 it make it as 15. So in the 15, how many 3s are there? Yes, 1 3 is 3, 2 3s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 4 3s are 12, and 5 3s are 15. So we can write 5 into 3. Okay, 5 into 3 is 15. So 15 minus 15 is 0. So from here we can say 3 and 25 are also the factors of 75. Okay, next we can check it for 4th table. So 4th table means it's not possible, because if you divide means you can know that. Okay, ma. Next we can divide by 5. 5 we can do it, because at the ones place we have 5. We know that in the multiplication table of 5, if you have 0 and 5 means we can divide that number. So here we have 5. So we can definitely, we can say 75 can able to divide by 5. So we can take the divisor as 5. So in the 7, how many 5s are there? Yes, 1 5 is 5. 1 5 is 5. Next we can subtract 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5 is what, ma? 2. So we got the remainder as 2. Next we have to bring down the 5 now. So 2 and 5, it will make it as 25. So in 25, how many 5s are there? Yes, 5 5s are 25. So 5 into 5 is 25. So 25 minus 25 is 0. Okay, from here we can say 5 and 15 are the factors of 75. Okay, next if you take it 6 means it is not possible to divide by 6. 7 also we can't able to divide the 7 by 75. Okay, 8 also not possible, 9 not possible, 10 also not possible. So from here we can write the answer thus: 1, that means the divisor, okay, 1, comma next divisor is 3 and next divisor is 5. Next we can take the quotient value, that is 15, comma 25 and 75. And 75 are the factors of 75, okay. So we can divide the 75 by 1 first. So you will get the remainder 0. Likewise, if you divide it by 3 means you will get the remainder 0. Next, if you divide by 5 means you will get the remainder 0. From here we can say 1 and 75, likewise 3 and 25, and 5 and 15 are the factors of 75. So we can write the answers thus: 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 15 comma 25 and 75 are the factors of 75. Okay. So third problem, we have to find out the factors of 32. Okay, we have to find out the factors of 32. So we can write the solution and we can start to divide the 32 by 1 first. Okay, so how many 1s are there in the 3? Yes, 3 1s are there. So 3 into 1 is 3. So 3 minus 3 is 0. Next we can bring down the next value. That means we can bring down the 2. So if you bring down the 2 means how many 1s are there, ma? In the 2? Yes, 2 1s are 2. So we can write the 2 in the quotient, and as well as we can write the 2 here. So 2 minus 2 is 0. Okay, so we can say 1 and itself. That means 1 and 32 are the factors of 32. Next we can divide the 32 by 2. Because in the 1's place we have the even number as 2. So we can say this number 32 can be divided by 2. So we can divide it by the 10's place first. So in the 3, how many 2's are there, ma? Yes, in the 3 there are 1. 2 is there. 1, 2 is 2. The 3, 1, 2 is there. So next if you subtract 3 minus 2 is 1. Next we can bring down the 1's place value. That means 2. So 1 and 2, it will make it as 12. In the 12, how many 2's are there? Yes, 6. 6 2's are 12, isn't it, ma? 6 into 2 is 12. So 12 minus 12 is 0. So from here, if you're dividing the 32 by 2 means you will get the remainder 0. So we can say 2 and 16 as the factors of 32. Okay, 2 and 16 are the factors of 32. Next, if you are taking 3 means, we know that 10 3s are 30. No. Next, we have only 2 only. So, you will get 2 as a balance. So, it's not possible. Next, we can check it for 4. Yes, 4 table we can possible to divide. Is it, ma? So, if you divide 32 by 4 means, yes, sir. Check it the 4th table, ma. 1 4 is 4, 2 4s are 8, 3 4s are 12, 4 4s are 16, 5 4s are 20. Then 6 4s are 24, 7 4s are 28 and 8 4s are 32, isn't it? 8 4s are 32 we will get. So 8 into 4 means 32. Okay, 4 into 8, otherwise 8 into 4 means 32. Next, if you subtract 32 minus 32 is 0. So from here, if you divide 32 by 4 means we will get the quotient as 8 and the 0 as the remainder. Okay, next we can check it for 5, 5th table. So 5th table also we won't get 32, you will get 30 only. So 2 will be remainder. Then 6th table also we won't get the product as 32, no. Then 7th table not possible. 8th table we can do it, but we already did it this. Isn't it, ma? 8 into 4 is 32. Otherwise 4 into 8 is 32. So same thing only. No need to repeat once again. Then 9th table also we won't get. Then 10th table also we won't get the product as 32. So from here we can say that 32 having the factors as 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 and 32. Okay, so 32 having the factors. What are the factors, ma? 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 and 32 are the factors of 32. Okay, now we can write the answer. Thus, 1, comma, okay, this is a 1. Then 2, comma, 4, comma, 8, comma, 16 and 32. Okay, and 32 are the factors of 32. Okay, so we can write the answer. Thus 1 comma 2 comma 4 comma 8 comma 16 and 32 are the factors of 32. Okay, have you understood this? So like this method you have to do this homework. Okay, so you have the 4th question as 22 and 5th question you have to find out the factors of 63. Okay, ma. Next we can move on to the next Roman number. So next Roman number 4, we are going to find out the common factors of the following. Okay, find the common factors of the following. So here we are going to find out the factors of the given numbers. Next we have to find out the common one. Okay, ma. So listen, first question, we have to find out the factors of 18 first. Next we have to find out the factors of 12. Okay, what's the first step, ma? The step one is we have to find out the factors of 18 first. Okay, second step we have to find out the factors of 12. And third step, we have to find out the common numbers. Okay, we have to find out the common factors of 18 and 12. Okay, so we can start to do this problem. So as usual, in the second Roman number, we did know, ma, finding the factors using multiplication method. That format we can do it. Okay, so we can write the solution. And then we can write. We know that. So what we know, ma? If you want to get the product as 18 means, we know that first if you multiply 18 into 18, you will get the product as 18. Okay. So 1, 9, 18 are the factors of 18. Next, 2 into 9 is equal to 18, isn't it? If you multiply 2 into 9, you will get 18. So we can say 2 and 9 also factors of 18. Next, 3 table. If you take it 3 table means 3 into 6 is equal to 18, isn't it? 3 into 6 is 18. Next, 4th table, we can't able to do it. 4th table, you won't get 18 as the product. Then 5th table also, we won't get the product as 18. Then 6th table, already we returned. 7th table also, we won't get. 8th table, we won't get the 18 as the product. Then 9th table, already we returned. Okay, no need to write again. Okay, 9 into 2. That means 9 into 2, otherwise 2 into 9 also 18 only. So this much only. Okay, these are the factors of 18. So we can say 1, 18, then 2, 9 and 3 and 6 are these factors of 18. So likewise, so this is the first step. Okay, so first step we have to find out the factors of 18 by using the multiplication method. So next we can write the, we can find out the factors of 12. So we can write as like that. We know that. So we have to find out the factors of 12. So we can start from 1. So 1 into 12 is 12. 1 into 12 is 12. Likewise, 2 into 6 is 12, isn't it? 6 2s are 12. That is 2 into 6 is 12. 2 6 are 12 or 6 2s are 12. Okay. Next, 3 table. If you are taking 3 table means 3 into 4 is 12. 3 4s are 12. Likewise, 4 3s are 12. Okay. Then, 3 table, 3 into 4 is 12. 4 table also same thing only. 5 table we won't get 12. 6th table already we return, okay, 2 into 6, otherwise 6 into 2. Then 7th table we won't get 12 as the product. Then 8th table also we won't get 9th, 10th, we won't get the 12 as the product, okay. So, first step we have to find out the factors of the given first number, that is 18, okay. So, first number is 18, so we can write, we know that, and write the multiplication factors, okay. We know the multiplication factors of the 18, so that is 1 into 8 is 18 is 18. 2 into 9 is 18. Likewise, 3 into 6 is 18. Next, we have to find out the factors of 12. Okay, this is the first step. And second step is, we have to find out the factors of the second number. So, second value is 12. So we can write, we know that 1 into 12 is 12, 2 into 6 is 12, 3 into 4 is 12. Okay. Afterwards, okay, this is the first and second step, and third step we can write. Okay, just we can leave it one line and write 1 comma. Okay, this is, we are going to write the factors of 18. Okay, so 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, then 6 comma, then 9 and 18 are the factors of 18. Okay, have you understood, ma? So first we can write the factors of 18 as 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 6 comma, 9 and 18 are the factors of 18. Next we can write the next line, the factors of 12. Okay, what are the factors of 12? Yes, 1 comma, 2 comma, then 3 comma, then 4 comma, 6 comma, sorry, 6 comma, not 8, 6 and 12 are the factors of 12. Okay, are the factors of 12. I understood, now this is the third step. Okay, so we have to write down the factors of the each number. So first number is 18, so we can write 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 6 comma, 9 and 18 are the factors of 18. Then second value is 12, so we can write 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, 6 and 12 are the factors of 12. Next we have to find out the common factors. Okay, we have to find out the common factors. Okay, so to find the common factors, we have to see the same numbers. Okay, same numbers are appear in this two factors or not. So see here, ma, from here we can say 1 and 1 is the common factor. Now just we can circle it. Okay, so for the identification we can circle it. Then 2 is the same factor we have in the 18 and 12, and 3 also the same factors we have. Next 4, it's not here, but 6 we have, isn't it? In the both the numbers we have 6, so we can circle like this. Okay, circle it like this. Then 9 we won't have, and 12 it's not there, and 18 is not there. So from here we can say 1, 2, 3 and 6 are the common factors of 18 and 12. Okay, so here they asked to find out the common factors of the following numbers. No, so first we have to find out the factors of the first given number. Next we have to find out the factor of the second given number. Next we can take and write the factors of the first and the second number. Then fourth thing, we have to find out the common numbers. We have to find out the common numbers. Then we can write, therefore, 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 and 6 are the common factors, are the common factors of 18 and 12. Okay, I understand, ma? So last thing we have to write, therefore 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 and 6 are the common factors of 18 and 12. Have you understood, ma, this? So first thing we have to find out the factors of 18. Next thing we have to find out the factors of 12. Next we have to take and write the factors of the given numbers. Fourth thing, you have to find out the common numbers. Okay, common numbers we have, same numbers we have in the factors of 18 and 12. At the last, we can take and write the common numbers alone. Okay, that means 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 and 6 are the common factors of 18 and 12. Okay, next we can move on to the second problem. So second problem, we have to find out the common factors of 35 and 45. We have to find out the common factors of 35 and 45. So first we can find out the factors of 35 first. Then we have to find out the factors of 45. Afterwards, we have to take and write the factors of the given numbers. Then we have to find out the common thing and we can write the answer. So first we can write the solution to start this answer. Okay, so solution, next we can write, we know that, yes, we know that what, ma? First we can take and write the 1 and the number itself as the factor of 35. No, so we can write 1 into 35 is 35. Then next, in the second table you will get the product is 35, na? 35 you will get or not, ma? You won't get, isn't it, ma? Because in the 35, the ones place value is 5. It's an odd number. So in the second table, we will not get the odd number as the product. No, it will get the in the ones place as the even number only. So we can't able to take and write the second table. Then third table thing in mind, third table you will get 35 as the product. Own, we won't get. Then fourth table, Yes, fourth table also we won't get the 35 as the product. No. So next thing it for fifth table, yes, we will get 35. So 5 into which number we will get the 35 ma? Yes, 5 into 7. 5 sevens are 35. Isn't it? Next is sixth table. No, it's not possible. We won't get the 35 as the product there. Then 7th table we already returned. 5 sevens are 35, otherwise 7 fives are 35. Same thing only. Then 8th table and then 9th, 10th table we won't get the 35 as the product. So from here we can say only these two values. That is 1 into 35 and 5 into 7 are the factors of 35. Next we can write the next value. So next value is 45. No. So we can write, we know that. So what we know, 1 into 45 is 45, isn't it? 1 into 45 is 45. Next, 2 table also we can't able to write because in the 1's place we have 5. That is odd number. You won't get the odd number in the second table. Okay, isn't it, ma? In the second table we won't get the 1's place as an odd number. So next we can do it for 3 tables. 3 table we will get. So 3 into 15, okay. 3 into 15 is 45. Okay, if you multiply, 15 into 3 is 45, okay. Next one, in the fourth table you will get, no, it's not possible, isn't it, ma? In the fourth table also we won't get the 45 as the product. Next, fifth table we will get, no, isn't it? Yes, 5 into 9 is 45, isn't it, ma? 5 into 9 is 45. So next, sixth table, seventh table and eighth table also we won't get the 45 is the product. But 9th table will get 9 5s are 45. So already we have returned 5 9s are 45. The 10th table also we won't get. Okay. So these are the factors of 35 and these are the factors of 45. So from here we can write 1, comma. Okay. This 1, comma, 5, comma, 7 and 35 are the factors of 35. Okay, so from here we can write it as 1 comma 5 comma 7 comma 35 are the factors of 35. The next one we can write the factors of 45. That means 1 comma then 3 comma then 5 comma 9 comma 15 and 45 are the factors of 45. Okay, these are the factors of 45. Okay. 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 9 comma 15 and 45 are the factors of 45. So next thing what we have to do, it may be how to find out the common factors. Okay, common numbers, same numbers we have to find it from here. So from here we can say 1 is the common factors of the 35 and 45. No. Then next step is 3 is there. No. But 5 we have in the both the factors. So we can take it the 5 as the factors. So while you are rounding these numbers, use the pencil to round. Okay, man. Don't use the pen to round the numbers. Okay. So 5 are the common factors of 35 and 45. Then next, 7 is not having here. 9 also not having here. 15, 35, 45. We have one time only. Isn't it, ma? So from here, we can say, therefore, 1 and 5. Okay, 1 and 5. Two numbers only. No. So 1 and 5 are the common. Okay, here we have to write factors. Okay, that number, these are the factors of 35 alone. No. So we can write these are factors of 35 and 45. Here we have to write 1 and 5 are the common. Okay, we have to find out the common factors. No, so common factors of 35 and 45. Okay, I understood this. So 1 and 5 are the common factors of 35 and 45. Okay, have you understood this? So here the first question is we have to find out the common factors of 35 and 45. So first we have to find out the factors of 35 in the multiplication method. Next we have to find out the factors of 45 in the multiplication method. Next we have taken write the factors of each number, each given numbers. Okay, so like this we have to write. Okay, so 1 comma 5 comma 7 and 35 are the factors of 35 and 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 9 comma 15 and 45 are the factors of 45. Next we have to find out the common numbers. Okay, among these two factors, what are the common factors, ma? 1 and 5. So just we have to circle with the pencil and next we can write therefore 1 and 5 are the common factors of 35 and 45. Understood this? So children, you have only one homework. You want to find out the common factors of 14 and 20. Okay, you have to find out the common factors of 14 and 21. Okay, ma? So do the homework the Roman number 3 and as well as the Roman number 4. Okay, and remaining portions we can discuss in the next class. Okay, bye. Thank you so much.